You're banging in trees, you're bumping off tussocks, going over rocks. One of the main tasks at that time for me was to build a sled that was almost indestructible.
Dog sleds have changed a lot over the years.
In the 1800s, the sleds were large basket sleds with the wood slats for the bed. They were a lot larger because they weren't just going out for fun. If they were using a dog team, they were usually traveling a long distance and were carrying a great deal of goods.
Modern racing has transformed sleds from heavy, wooden, and slow to light, fast, and able to take a beating.
We've used a lot of different materials, a lot of plastics, a lot of aluminum, a lot of carbon fiber.
So what are the main parts of a dog sled?
The runners. You have to have something for the sled to slide on the snow. If it's 30 above like it is today, we have a certain plastic that works for that. If it's 50 degrees below, we have a certain plastic that works for that. And the next part is the bed. That's where you put your gear, it rides in there. Those are held up in the air off the ground by what's called the stanchions. And these are the vertical members of the sled that come up and attach to what's called the driving bow or handlebar. The other main component that every sled has to have is some kind of front end, what we call brush bow. If you're coming at a tree, it's triangle shaped and you can't steer around the tree. When you hit the tree, it deflects you off.
That's how you keep a sled moving, but what about stopping?
So we have what's called the brake bar or claw brake. And then once you stop them, we use what's called a snow hook and we just jam it down in the snow or ice and it holds the team from going. Now the other way that we kind of keep the team speed controlled is by using what's called the drag mat or stomp pad. And so it actually creates friction and holds the team slower. We stand on that with both feet or 1 foot or whatever amount of friction you need to control the team.
Those are the individual pieces, but every sled design is at least a little unique.
Especially in the 1,000-mile races, what's called the tail dragger seat. It's nice to be able to take a load off and sit down. And so usually what I do is I put my cooler in this bag and then I sit on that. And I try to do that as much as possible because when I get to a checkpoint, it's go, 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 go. I gotta take care of those dogs. I gotta keep moving so that then I can lay down and take a nap quick so that we can get back on the trail.
And each musher has their own style and their own favorite sled setup.
There are a lot of people who like to build their own sleds. I mean, mushers are very, we all like to do our own thing and do it our own way. And so you see a lot of people build their own sleds in Alaska. So out of anywhere, there's probably the most sled builders in Alaska.
Sleds have come a long way over the last 100 years, from traditional wooden sleds to ones made from cutting edge materials. A dog sled has to be light, strong, and comfortable in order to be a great tool.